step into the ring.
Alrighty, here we go. We are live. Good evening, everybody. This is The Atomic Punk, and welcome to a special stream. We are streaming a Smash Grounds crew battle tonight as part of Monday Night Smash. It's a crew battle featuring heroes versus villains. I've already introduced myself. I'm The Atomic Punk. He is Super Smash Bailey.
What's up, stream?
And we are going to guide you through this crew battle. It's an 8v8. Three stock matches. That means we got to get through 24 stocks before somebody goes down. Should be a hell of a thing. And it looks like, let's see, we're going to be starting off the heroes and villains battle. We've got Monster with Mario and Bruh with Bowser.
This should be interesting.
Evil's Bane, thank you for the follow.
Anyway.
I think that puts me two followers away from getting to 50, and I can finally be an affiliate.
Nice.
Like, I got a lot of followers off of that tournament this Saturday, but that's water under the bridge. That's the past. We're in the now. And Crystal Link, thank you for the follow.
One more follow. One more. Nice.
All right, let's see. We need... Can we get a... Looks like we just need to get Monster in here and we'll be all ready to go.
Yeah, you got a team that you're rooting for, Atomic?
I'm going to try to be unbiased as the commentator here, but...
Me too.
Let's see. Let me do a quick rundown of the rosters on Team Heroes. We've got Monster, Watercraft, Iroh, Squeesh, Luigi, Leo, Spooky, and Kerbling. On the villains, we've got Bruh, Cal, Banff, Ramen, Bane, Elric, Shiny, and Aura King. Some of those names are shortened from what they actually are, but let's see if we can go ahead and get set up here. Looks like we've got Monster and Bruh ready to go. All right, in the chat has been blowing up with the emotes. Everyone is excited for this one. This is what I like to see.
Yeah.
So let's see if we can get this underway very soon. Look at that. We got Watercraft with the emotes. We got Monster. We got Shiny. We got Banff. The chat is popping off. The Smash Grounds people are in force tonight. I love it.
You know it.
All right, tell Monster and Bruh they may begin when ready, because we are certainly ready.
Right.
Oh my god, I've never seen so many emotes in my chat. Usually my chat is dead.
Oh my gosh.
Guys, this warms my heart. There's actually activity in my chat.
This is amazing.
Here we go. All right, here it is. We are starting off Heroes versus Villains, and it's the classic matchup, the video game rivalry. It's Mario and Bowser! And the Heroes versus Villains crew battle is underway! The classic everyman character Mario against his big, bruising nemesis. And a bit early on the percentages to start off, nice command grab into the side B. Try to build up that quick percentage. And now gonna play the distance game, I guess, with the fire breath, but a nice little sweep right there by Mario, and here we go. Monster, a very capable Mario. He is either his ZSS or his Mario I've typically faced quite a bit. Let's see what he can do against Bruh. I have not seen Bruh before. He's a newcomer to the Discord, joining us for this crew battle, so it remains to be seen exactly what he can bring to the table, but there's that command grab using the platform. Now Monster gotta try to regroup here. All blocks the down air into the, I believe that was the up B out of shield. Oh, nice sliding kick for the dash attack. And Mario, this is perilous for Monster here. Goes for the Bowser Bomb. Gets out from underneath it. And a smash attack First blood for Team Heroes. Nice turnaround, but ooh, bruh, very quickly evens it up. On a footstool. You didn't need to do that to him.
Yeah, like, was the footstool necessary?
I don't think you need... the last thing I would want is someone like Bowser coming down on my head.
Yeah.
Just saying.
Yeah.
Here we go. Oh, the down air gets away from it. Can Monster take back the lead? Hopefully he can avoid having percentage built up on him for a quick revenge kill. Oh, but the down air! Air dodges the up smash. Perfect timing. If he had not done that or had timed it wrong, that would have been bye-bye on that stock.
Indeed.
Oh, the command grab and uses the platform just to ensure that he goes into the blast zone. And Bruh is ahead. Could we see the first match go down and could Team Villain capture the all-important first match? Not if Monster has anything to say. Here we go. One stock apiece already. And I will be updating the scoreboard after the conclusion of the match. Woo-hoo-hoo! Clutch shield on that down smash. And here we go. Oh, nice down air. I thought he was gonna... Oh, and the drop kick's gonna do it!
And Team Villain's in the lead.
And Bruh clinches the first match for the Villains.
Wow.
A blistering opening match for this crew battle. What a start. Going down to final stock. And Evil's Bane is right. It is a Bruh moment. Bruh certainly had his moment on that one. Alright, so, and I believe from this point on, we will be conducting it like a standard crew battle. We did start it off with the cannon matchup, but I believe from this point, we will see a different hero step in, but Bruh will be staying in, if I'm understanding everything correctly.
Wow, look at this activity in the chat, man.
Or, oh no, perhaps not. Perhaps we are going, It was never, I don't think it was ever fully clarified to me exactly how the setup was going to be.
Mm.
Oh my god, the emotes in this chat. This chat is going crazy.
Right?
You guys are amazing, I love it. Why can't my chat be like this all the time?
Maybe it's because I'm involved this time, I don't know.
But enough about me. We need to get this crew battle continuing. So,
yep.
To keep the scoreboard in check, with that victory, we have a one-stock difference. Villains maintaining a one-stock lead with 22 stocks remaining. The Heroes down by one with 21. But this is only the beginning. It's early yet. Mm. And Bruh will be going into the next battle. He will have to take off two of his stocks because he is down to his last one.
Yep.
So we got Bruh back in, awaiting the next hero to try to step up. It will be interesting to see who steps up next, because I believe at this point they are most likely strategizing right now.
And I believe the next hero that is going to come up soon is Watercraft or Donkey Kong.
If we are indeed going in the order here.
Yeah. And soon we'll be seeing two heavyweights going at it. DK versus Bowser. This ought to be interesting.
I mean, that was a hot start to the series, and I was kind of thinking Monster was possibly gonna get it, but that down smash just ended any hopes of Monster potentially pulling it off. And
wait,
we're gonna see who comes. Oh, Leo. Leo with the Pokemon trainer. This is interesting. Let's see how this goes.
Oh, so everything is randomized, I guess.
All right. Or perhaps they thought Leo was the next best choice. But here we go. Battle 2 of the crew battle. Can Bra continue his run for the villains as Leo steps up for the heroes with Pokemon Trainer? But of course, Bra has to take off his first two stocks.
There we go.
And now we actually get started, and it's Turtle versus Turtle. Reptile versus Reptile here, and right now the big Turtle is winning the match, running away right now.
Wow.
Gotta really try to pick your spot and move in here with Squirtle, but perhaps he can build up some early percentage and then switch to Ivysaur to really go to work.
Yeah.
Okay, here comes, oh my goodness, lands right in front of the smash, and here is Ivysaur coming out. The workhorse, really, of the Pokemon Trainer character. Good spot dodge to avoid the grab, and another spot dodge. Avoiding the grabs, Charizard comes out, but is switched out quickly. Leo, I don't think Leo could really have afforded to lose a stock here. Oh, he's charged up. Oh, he caught him on the get up!
Wow.
And that is a quick finish. So the heroes take a stock off, but they are still going to trail, courtesy of Leo dropping that early stock, but it is still close.
Indeed.
Caught him on the getup. I wonder what Bra was trying to do. I'm surprised he didn't try a getup attack or some other way to try to get up, because he was set up completely by that F smash.
Yeah. To be honest, I thought Watercraft Donkey Kong would go up next. But I guess not.
Alright, so that leaves. Who is going to be next to step up for the villains? Let me actually start crossing names off here. So, Mario and Bowser are both out. The Mushroom Kingdom, the Mario franchise, does not have any representatives left.
Nope.
And I'm seeing in the chat, it looks like Aura King will be stepping up next. He is going to be the Mewtwo representative, so we're going to get the Pokemon franchise out of the way for Battle 3.
I'm surprised that Leo, like, the Pokemon hero for this is Pokemon Trainer and not Pikachu.
Well, we had Pikachu as an option, but PT was claimed first, which I guess they just went with him instead.
Yeah.
So here we go. I guess Aura is going to get set up here. And again, the stages, as you've seen, ladies and gentlemen, the stages for this crew battle are random, but they are taken from the EVO 2019 stage set. And indeed, the Mewtwo is coming out. Here we go.
Pokemon versus Pokemon. Here we go.
Battle 3.
That'll be interesting.
Now, of course, Leo will have to start off by sacrificing a stock, but perhaps he can get something going here. Like, it's been close so far, but these kinds of crew battles can turn into a runaway very quickly. A nice dash attack, just waiting out the switch, and a good parry. So let's see what this Mewtwo can do. Mewtwo is one of those characters I've tried to main, along with my Pikachu, so let's see how Aura does. And right now he's getting juggled a little bit.
Yeah.
Oh, tries to catch him with confusion. Oh, you knew. I was thinking Ivysaur was going to attempt the down air spike. Oh, tried to do a nice little combo with the down air into up air. That would have been a hell of a thing. Here we go. Oh, there's the spike. There we go. That's what Leo needs. He needs to get first blood here. Now, can he quickly take the next two without something happening to any more of his stocks? If he can get through this without losing any more stocks, Team Heroes will be in the lead. Once again, Mewtwo Aura trying to catch the approach with the confusion, the side B, but he hasn't gotten it so far.
Nope.
Oh, good shield. Oh, but he can't get anything off of it. Thinking maybe he could have gotten a grab. Nice tether, switching out to Ivysaur. Woohoo! Oh, and did he spot dodge the confusion?
Wow, that's amazing.
Amazing movement and tech here from Leo with Pokemon Trainer. I am very impressed. Oh, nice tail slap. Just a simple forward tail. Tries to catch him with the up smash. Doesn't do so. Here's a grab. Up air? No. Oh, tried to read. Oh, the confusion. Oh, but he can't get anything off of it. The back throw. He's got two kill throws, especially, and I think he's approaching kill percent for both of them. He might have kill percent for a back throw at the ledge or an up throw, but the up smash is going to do it. And Leo is down to his last stock. Can he at least take one more for the heroes? Nice up air. Has to teleport to make it back. It's a good thing we're not on Unova League here. Oh, and the tech chase. So close to the blast zone, but he can't make it back. I wonder if Aura thought he had gone past it or something, because it looked like he could have teleported or something, but we are down to one stock here. So, can Leo finish off Aura here and keep alive for his team? That up smash, though, not going to help his cause. Oh, nice little string there from Leo, getting in a few hits. The withdraw is going to go through the attack. There's the neutral air. And, oh, the back throw setting something up. Went for a spike! Oh, both go for a spike and miss. The up air, not enough yet. He went way up high on that one. Oh, gets through it with the forward air. Ivysaur, get off the platform, Leo! Oh, just misses the down air! The back throw! The Vine Whip! The up air! And that's it!
Sure.
Alright, so, I believe that's going to be 18 stocks now for the villains. 1 and 19 for the heroes. So with that performance, the heroes jump into the lead. An absolute belter of a game 3.
Indeed.
Whew! Some good matches so far. So that is two characters down for the villains, one character down still so far for the heroes. Leo putting in the clutch work, especially in that last game. A lot of very close calls for both of them, but it's Leo who clutches it out.
And his Pokemon trainer is still in.
But can he maintain that momentum, especially now that he is down to the last stock for him? It depends on who comes out next.
Yeah.
But to eliminate two off the opposing team is a heck of a thing. So who will be coming out next?
I'm looking at the Heroes vs. Villains channel on Discord right now. I think of all the Pokemon in Leo's arsenal, his best is Ivysaur.
Well, Ivysaur is technically the workhorse, and it's going to be Evil's Bane coming out next. Bane will be representing Kirby with the Meta Knight, so we'll see how that goes.
Pokemon Trainer versus Meta Knight, wow. Thankfully, Meta Knight is not the best character in the game, just like Brawl.
Yeah, this ain't Brawl.
Yeah.
Go back to 2008.
Yeah. Thankfully, Meta Knight is not the best character in the game.
I don't know, I'd kind of like to go back to 2008. I was younger back then.
Yeah.
Adulthood hadn't ruined me yet. But anyway, I'm not here to talk about my personal problems. Here we go. Evils is in the arena. We already know what his character's going to be. It matches his icon.
Yep.
I guess we'll be seeing final preparations soon. This is going to be match number 4 of Heroes versus Villains. And it looks like we're just about ready. And here we go.
Leo with female Pokemon trainer and Evil Bane with Dark Meta Knight.
So here we go. It is 19-18. The Heroes out in front. Mm-hmm. Of course, Leo will have to sacrifice his first 2 stocks. He's going to have to get it all done on 1 life.
Yeah.
Given what he's shown us so far, I'm not going to discount him, but Evils is pretty good with this Meta Knight, so it's going to be an uphill battle, but good early start for Leo with the early 20%, a quick 20. Nice grab into a down throw. A quick 44%, 0 to 44, 0 to 62, okay. Uh-huh. Bane hasn't even, I was just about to say, Bane hasn't even gotten a hit in. He interrupted the commentator's curse before I could actually act it out, but the up air! Here comes Ivysaur, this is where the work gets done. Oh, nice dash grab. The Razor Leaf to interrupt the approach, and there's an up air! Sends him up into the upper blast line, and his first blood for Leo.
So as you said, you can't
count. Whoa, he sends himself off the stage! Oh, no!
Man.
Oh, my goodness, what just happened?
I don't even know.
Oh, dear. Like, I have to think something had gone wrong there, because he sent himself off the stage, but regardless, Leo has been eliminated, but despite knocking him out, Bane lost his stock as well, so despite that, the Heroes still lead 18-17.
Yeah.
Like, I can't help but think, was that a bad input, or what happened there? Because I don't know what Leo was trying to go for. And all Bane had to do was just hit him once and just completely, I guess, mess up his recovery. Like, something did not go right there for Leo. We were getting all hype. I was getting all hype. I'm like, this is going to be good. He got that up air and everything. And then it just a flat finish. But nonetheless, it's evened up now in terms of characters who are left. So who's going to step up next for the Heroes?
Curveling is up next for Kirby.
Ah, we're going to go with the canon matchup.
Kirby versus Meta Knight.
Although technically, I mean, me personally, I've never really viewed Meta Knight as a villain because sometimes he's actually an ally for Kirby.
Do you think Meta Knight is an anti-hero?
I think he's more anti-hero, rival for Kirby, but I ain't the guy who makes the games.
Oh.
Yeah. Alright, here we go. Looks like we're just going to go right into it. So it's going to be Kirby and Meta Knight here. So can Kerbling finish what Leo started?
3, 2, 1.
And we're going on FD. Well, it might be the final destination for one of these two. Evil is going to take off his stock. And here we go.
Yep, here we go.
Kirby Superstar, anyone?
Yeah.
Although in this case, it's not Meta Knight who's taking revenge this time. It's Kirby trying to avenge his fallen comrade after a very unfortunate finish. Oh, tries to stage spike him, it looked like. And thank you, Watercraft, for the follow. I'm surprised he hadn't followed me yet. But nonetheless, here we go. Very interesting matchup here.
Nice side
B from Evil. Oh, he tried to catch him with the final cutter. And a footstool just to mock him, I guess. And here we go. Kirbling trying to put something together. Nice up B out of shield.
Nice shuttle
here. Yeah. And Kirby at 99. He's going to try to drag him down. He does. But Bane has all his jumps and the up B. And that is going to be a stock. That's going to even up the scoreboard for the time being. Although, again, I won't be updating it until after the match is over because I don't want to miss anything. But it is 17-all at this point. Oh, tries to read the landing, but the F smash is going to do it, and Evils is down to his last stock. Kerbling has two stocks to play with. Can he close it out? Nice little string of up tilts there. Oh, I believe that was a neutral air. Nice job getting over the jabs. Oh, cuts off the final cutter. A little lag spike there, but doesn't seem to be affecting things too much. Oh, good shield on the down air. Oh, no! Ah, who am I kidding? He's got plenty of jumps. He was totally gonna make it back. Oh, the cat pushes him off again! And a down smash! So close to that blast zone. He's going out for it!
He made it back, wow.
Kerbling was going out for it. And why wouldn't he? He has two stocks to play with, but I think he wants to be a little more careful and he might lose that stock. The down B! And he got it!
Wow.
And Kerbling, despite losing a stock, takes it anyway. So let me see here. Let me look at the score. Look, so it would be two falls for the villains. I guess it would be 17-15. Now we're starting to see a little bit of separation here, but still not by much. Kerbling, will still have two stocks of his to play with. And Evil's Bane is out. Could not have asked for a more competitive crew battle. This has been a very entertaining series thus far.
Yeah, especially since I'm here.
And Side B Studios, thank you for the follow. And I think, ladies and gentlemen, I think I've finally hit 50 followers on Twitch. Thank you guys so much for coming out. Not just for Smash Grounds. Obviously, we got something great going with the Discord on Smash Grounds. But thank you for coming out and supporting my channel. It means a lot to me personally. And we still got quite a ways to go, ladies and gentlemen.
And
so don't go away yet.
And Cow will be up next with this King K. Rule.
Oh, baby. And this K. Rule is something fierce, let me tell you. And we're going to go right into it, it looks like.
Kirby versus King K. Rule.
Oh boy. The Battle of the K's. Here we go.
Yeah, but the question is, which K is the best?
Oh boy. I don't know. Like, I mean, Kerbling showed some pretty good stuff in that last battle, but this Cow, or Caw Caw, as he's calling himself for Halloween, his K. Rule is vicious. So it remains to be seen if Kirby can do it. I mean, big, strong heavyweight versus a little puffball. I don't know.
Yeah.
He's getting some percentage on. He's got the percentage lead. But here's a grab, the back throw. Throws out the crown, the neutral air. Use that big belly to his advantage. Oh, you picked a bad time to go for a roll.
Yeah, the blunderbuss is very strong.
Oh, clutch shield! That would have killed! That would have been the end of things on that stock. Let's see if Kerbling can at least take the stock. He's got the hammer, but no hammer time for you. Down B, not quite enough. K. Rule quite a bit heavier than Meta Knight, so it isn't going to quite work. But now he's in a tough situation here, and he's back aired up. Or is that the forward air? I can't remember which.
It's forward air.
He gets forward aired into oblivion. But let's see if Kerbling can at least take a stock. If he can at least take a stock, at worst, the series will become even between the two sides. So if Kerbling can at least take one stock, at worst, it would be even.
But Cow is doing really good with these attacks.
Oh my goodness! He had that F smash. That would have probably been it.
Yeah. not enough. Didn't
don't approach. Be very careful, Kerbling. You gotta pull something. Look out, here comes the crown.
The four tilt.
Oh, and a down air is gonna take it! And that is going to even the score. Kerbling, he got him up high into a high percentage, but just could not make the necessary kill shot. And we have an even scoreboard, and Kerbling is out.
His Kirby did really well.
This has just been back and forth, back and forth. It might come down to the wire. We might have a hell of a finish if we keep up this pace. But very costly, the Kerbling couldn't take at least one stock.
Yeah.
So essentially, whoever steps in next, it's basically going to be like we started the series over, because both competitors are going to come in with fresh stocks. And it's going to be Mr. Spooky with Pit.
Ooh.
Very interesting call here.
King K. Rool versus Pit. A big heavyweight crocodile versus an angel.
All right, let's see. Here we go. We're jumping right into it here. The score is tied. We have five fighters left per side. Here we go. Spooky versus Cow Cow. Spooky, aka Mr. Fluffy. Pit versus K. Rool. I know nothing about this matchup. Let's see what happens.
Yeah, let's see.
Can Spooky at least take a stock, keep it close? Because Cow Cow could easily start running away with this for his team. Cow is that type of player. He can be a game changer. Throws him. Oh, goes for the back air. That dunk would have turned Pit into a fallen angel on that one, because he would have been going straight to hell. Ooh, tried to catch him. Goes for a stage fight back air, but you're not going to get too many of those off of K. Rool, at least not in that particular instance. I'll try to snipe him. Shades of Armada from the Brawl days. There's a reason he's called the Swedish Sniper, and it's because of his play with Pit back in the day. Yeah, I know my Smash history. But anyway, back to this. Spooky, so far for the most part, playing it pretty... Ooh! Side B's his way back under the down air, but he's got to be... Oh, no. You just opened up a free hit there, Spooky. Makes it back. Tries to read him on the getup, and... Oh, they're rolling. They're dodging. Buried, and that's going to take a first stock.
Yeah, that's the thing about K. Rool. When you get buried, it's a free kill if you're at a high percent.
Pretty much. Like, don't even try to break out. He's going to get you.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Does he have the recovery? Yes, he does. Still trying to get the back air.
Oh, my God.
Okay, can he turn his crown again? Look out! The back... He teched it! But he can't... Does he make it? Oh, he's just short! And Spooky takes a stock. He finally got the stage spike, despite Cow Cow teching it. Ran out of gas on the recovery. Unbelievable turnaround. So it's still even in terms of the overall stock count. It's now 14 apiece, I believe. Oh, be careful, Spooky. Oh, but he gets grabbed on the getup. Oh, doesn't quite. The side B, gonna make it back, but he gets shot out of the blunderbuss, the crown coming out. Cow Cow trying everything to make it difficult for Spooky to make it back to the stage. Oh no, he missed the ledge, and that's gonna cost him dearly. Forward air, okay. Oh, the cave sends the cannonball back. Oh, the up air is coming out. Oh, he reflects it. And all the back air, the up air gets... Oh, says sit down, son. Down airs him into the platform. Spooky can get some kind of string together. Perhaps he can at least bring it to even stocks. Woo! I mean, he was going to miss anyway because of the spacing, but still, good shield. He's... I wonder why he's... Is he going to try? Oh, he went for a two frame. You're not going to get that against K. Rool. Not with his recovery. Because the rotors go through the stage. You're not going to get a two frame on K. Rool. Not with his recovery.
No.
Oh, he missed the back air!
There you go.
Oh, look out. Spooky in a perilous position right now. He could probably get killed at this percent.
Both players are hanging tough.
The cow does have the stock advantage. The back air's gonna do it! All right, here we go. Mr. Spooky at 114. Can he make it happen? Can he do it? Can he actually knock Cow Cow out of this series? Oh no, but he gets grabbed. The berry, and there it is. I shouldn't have said anything.
That is gonna
knock the heroes down to 12 stocks, and the villains jump out ahead, but again, only by 1 point. But a very tough fight. A very tough fight for Mr. Spooky with Pit. I am very impressed. Especially against Cow-Cow.
Cow-Cow K-Rool is ferocious.
Mr. Fluffy, Mr. Spooky, whatever you want to call him, he has nothing to be ashamed of after that. He almost knocked Cow-Cow out of the series. A very good performance, but not quite enough, but... Potentially, depending on who comes out next, the table could be set. We are down to 4 characters left on the heroes. And I don't know, whoever comes next could determine whether Cow Cow continues his journey or he goes down in defeat.
Yeah.
It all goes back to, imagine if Kerbling in his match had it taken at least a stock. Who knows, maybe Spooky could have knocked Cow out, but that is not how it turned out. And then again, we'll never know.
It was like Luigi with his fox.
Alright, Luigi coming in with the fox. This is going to be interesting.
K-Rool versus Fox.
All right, chat, are we having fun so far? It's been a great crew battle. Very close, very exciting.
Very good so far. Here we go, King K. Rool versus Fox McCloud.
All right, so Cow will have to sacrifice 2 of his stocks, obviously, so that is going to potentially help Luigi. Now, can Luigi take a stock without losing any in return? If he can at least do that, we'll have it even. It's now up to the heroes it's on the heroes to keep this going and try to give themselves a chance.
And here we go.
All right, and they begin. So let's see. I haven't seen Luigi's fox. I'm not sure if he really uses fox all that much, but we're gonna see if he can get it done here. Fox has always been a good character in every Smash Bros. Entry, so he goes right into the blunderbuss. Oh, cuts off the down smash. Cow was trying to read where he was going to land. Good spot dodge on the dash attack. Gets up right into a forward tilt. Oh, and a down air spike through the Firefox! That's how you deal with a flaming fox coming at you. You stomp on him.
Yeah.
Luigi could not afford to lose that stock, but nonetheless, he has to run it. He has to try and run it back here. Again, I was concerned about this when Cow Cow entered the fray. I was like, the villains could end up running away with it, because Cow Cow is one of the best players on the entire Discord, at least on Smash Grounds.
Yeah.
This is what I was afraid of when I saw Cal come out. Oh, and he buries him in a punch to the face. But does he... Oh, no. Oh. If this were Melee and he got that ledge steal, that would have been a stock. Oh, he missed the read. He had the read with that up smash. And this is not the situation Luigi wants to be in. Absolutely not. Looked like that down smash earlier would have had it. He's going to try to catch him here with something. Oh, and this is very bad for Luigi, and this is potentially very dicey for the heroes overall. He just has to get one stock, and he finally does, but at what cost?
Man.
The heroes now down to... I believe that's now 10 stocks.
And looks like Cow Cow in the Discord is happy.
I mean, Cow Cow finally goes down, but that could not have gone... I mean, obviously, Luigi got the victory, but that could not have gone worse for the heroes beyond just outright losing. I mean, Luigi could not avoid losing two of his stocks to Cal's one. I mean, he gets the knockout. That is the important thing. But still.
I mean, to be honest, if I was in this crew battle, I wouldn't do really well.
All right. I'm receiving word that Banff is going to be the next up for the villains.
And Bam is going with Ganondorf.
He is packing the Ganon, so... Oh boy.
We could potentially see a Doria here. But... You never know.
Very tough fight for Luigi and the heroes in general. I mean, Luigi got kind of fell into a hole right there against Cal. He finally got the stock, but again, at what cost? That could really hurt the heroes in the long run.
Yeah.
And Ganondorf is not Bamp's best character, but he's still very formidable, so I won't be surprised if he just straight up goes for a Ganon side right out of the gate and just ends it immediately.
Or a Doria.
Like, I won't be surprised if he just gets him off stage and at the first opportunity goes for a side B. I'm calling it. We'll see after Luigi sacrifices his two stocks and Banff is teabagging. Alright, here we go. Let's see what Luigi can do. Oh, side B goes for a read with a stomp, and oh, this could be... If he gets a zero... I was going to say, if he gets a zero to death...
That would have been bad.
There was a Doria attempt. Oh, shields the up smash, and here we go. Can Luigi at least take a stock, get something here, potentially soften up Bamp for whoever comes next? Oh my goodness, that was almost it. That's gonna do it!
And I think it's even now?
And now the heroes, their stock count falls into the single digits.
Ooh.
It is 12-9.
Oh, so the villains are still in the lead. Wow. The heroes have a huge mountain to climb. Now I wonder what hero will come up next. Mario.
Well, I was wrong. Banff did not go for a side B. I don't know, I would have liked him to have done it just for spite, but nope. It looks like, let's see who comes up next. We are down to Squeesh, Iroh, and Watercraft for the Heroes side. Iroh's gonna step up, here we go.
And we got a cannon fight, Link versus Ganon.
Can Iroh be the hero? Can he be the hero that the heroes need, but not the one they deserve? We'll see. We potentially could have seen Watercraft go Link, but Watercraft instead went with Donkey Kong for this crew battle. And a nice start off here for Iroh trying to... If he can just get the early stock and make Bamf play from behind, that's the key. He's got to get the early momentum and somehow maintain it. But Ganondorf is a character that can snatch the momentum away with his attacks. Like I've said it many times in the chat on Smashgrounds, when Ganondorf's attacks hits, I wince. Like they hurt just to watch! But he misses the Warlock Punch! And the F Smash both hits, hitting home, and Iroh is ahead.
Iroh's doing a really good
job here. Oh, he takes a forward tilt though, right to the back of the... Oh, look out! Oh, and a stage spike! He techs it! Or did he make it back, or did he help himself with the up B? I'm not sure which.
Yeah, I'm not sure which either.
It happened so fast.
Yeah.
Can Iroh get it done? Looking very solid with his Link, and hey, you gotta do that, Iroh. You gotta play lame. You gotta make Bamf approach. You don't have to approach, Iroh. Bamf has to. Oh, but the back throw. He's off stage. Oh, but he catches him with the last few hits of the up B. He dropped his shield. Wizard's foot, the bomb sends him up. Nice up B out of shield. Try to get just as a get off me kind of move. The oh, so close to the blast line. The bomb comes out. Oh, look out! And there's a stock. So even if Iroh ends up winning, it's still not going to be even. That edge guard, though, is that going to do it? Goes for the stage spike with the down B. Bamf could not get the tech. But look at this. Oh, goes for the up smash. He's still got a chance here. If he can at least cut it to a one-stock deficit, this can be turned around. This is not impossible. Oh, but it might be. It might still be a three-stock difference at this point. Oh, the down smash. He gets one hit of it. Nice aerial. Tries to snipe with the arrow. The boomerang. No! Iroh! No!
Poor Iroh.
Looked like a couple bad inputs off stage. And looks like that's gonna really put the heroes down in a hole.
Man.
And I think that loss, that may put this out of reach. Iroh was playing so well for so much of that match, and just... I don't even know what happened there. Just, I guess a bad input or two. He couldn't get the up B out in time. And he just dropped, so... This is about as bleak as it can be for the heroes right now.
Yeah. So...
Even if Bamf goes down in this next match... There's still three other fighters for the villains. We might not even see all of the villains in this crew battle before it's over.
So we got Watercraft, Donkey Kong, and Squeesh's Samus left.
Those two are gonna have to play out of their minds to try to bring this back.
Indeed.
That is just a heartbreaking way for Iroh to go down. He had so much going for him, and then just, I think it looks to me like he got greedy towards the end there.
Yeah.
I don't think he needed to go out there like that. I think he needed to probably be a little more patient, maybe try to get a read or something. I think he tried to do a little too much there at the very end. I think he thought he had something and couldn't finish it.
And looks like Wildcraft coming in with Donkey Kong.
All right.
Two heavy Watercraft's, one
Watercraft's catchphrase is huge. He's going to have to be huge if he wants to try to make this comeback. I mean, I think it's possible, but I don't think it's probable.
Yeah, and here we go. Ganondorf versus DK.
Banff and Watercraft. The thing working in Watercraft's favor is that, you know, Banff is going to be down to one stock. That is working in his favor. And I've seen this Donkey Kong. This Donkey Kong can do work.
Oh, okay.
Like, it was a, like, Watercraft had the choice of going Link or DK. Both of them are his best characters. He's also got a pretty solid Luigi.
Yeah, I'm
fine. Right now, Banff really building up early percents here. Big lead! Nearly over 100% difference on the damage here. Oh, but nice. Waiting out the spot dodge for the forward smash. Good spot dodge. Oh! Oh, no. Couldn't afford to lose that. Like, every stock counts at this point for the heroes. And that stock, he could ill afford to lose. I mean, this is a football game. And the heroes are in four down territory. They have to make every play count.
Yeah.
Oh, but the giant punch is going to take it.
And Banff is out.
So if nothing else, the villains do go down to single digits on their stock count. But it's still a four stock difference.
But nevertheless, Banff finally gets taken down.
And it looks like they've already made their decision for the villains. It looks like it's going to be Shiny with Dark Pit coming out next.
Sadly, we won't be able to see Pit versus Dark Pit tonight. Right, oh well.
Alright, here we go. What can Watercraft do against Shiny using Dark Pit? Speaking with Shiny earlier, he says he's got quite a bit of experience, apparently, with Dark Pit. So, we'll see how this plays out.
DK versus DP.
And we're going to Lylat. Watercraft has to lose his first stock, and it looks like they are going to go ahead and get into it here. And an early string here for Shiny. Goes for the side B. Now just going to possibly just try to snipe him here, just build up damage from a distance. I like what Shiny's doing here. He's just going across the stage. He's going to force DK to approach him. Watercraft has to be the one who has to try to get in and get some hits here. Shiny can just bait him in and just hold him off from a distance. Very tough fight here, potentially, for Watercraft. Oh, tried to catch him with the side B. Doesn't get it. Spot dodges a grab attempt. Here's a cargo throw. Perhaps we could get some string going here. All Watercraft has to do is get that grab, get a cargo throw, and he can start doing things to you if you don't get away.
Yeah.
Here we go. Goes for a forward air, trying to spike. Doesn't get it. Oh, and the side B, but he lives off of it. Air dodges, comes down, avoids getting two framed. The dash attack sends him off. And the down B for the slap. He said, sit down, son. The heroes aren't done just yet. Oh, excellent spot dodge to get away from the grab attempt. Oh, no. Yes, he can make it back. And once again, so close to the blast zone. Watercraft is definitely a survivor. And he grabs him out of the... grabs him out of the down smash. I guess he had invincibility frames from the get-up. Oh, but the dash attack's going to finish that stock. All right, Watercraft. At least take one more stock. Give Squeesh something to work with when he has to come out. Woo! Gets the up B to make... Oh, and he buries him! Oh, he could have followed up with something so much stronger, but he gets the up smash through the platform. All right, Watercraft. It's time to see just how huge you can be.
Yeah.
Oh, it gets him with the side B. Oh, he's going to try to bait him, force him to approach. Nice use of the arrows there. Missed times the air dodge, and this is percentage that Watercraft can't afford to build up. All the cargo throw. Could this be the start? Up air, triple up air, quadruple up air. Goes for the quintuple, doesn't get it. Oh, and he blocks the punch! Watercraft fighting with everything he's got. Woo! Tries to read the getup! Oh, and he punches through with the up B. Oh, Watercraft. Watercraft. Oh, he can't. Oh! Oh, the cargo throw. He's going to throw him off. And he's got it. Watercraft. Watercraft. Watercraft.
Nice.
Huge. If he were here in this voice chat, he'd be saying it, but I'll say it for him. Huge!
Yes.
Watercraft keeping the heroes alive.
And I'm not...
Clip that!
Yes, clip it. Yes. And even though I'm not part of the crew battle, Team Huge is still in. But the question is, are we going to see Helrix's Wolf or Ramen's Ridley?
That's the question. Watercraft is going to have to deal with either a fresh Ridley or a fresh Wolf on one stock.
Man.
Elric is coming in. That's what they're saying in the Discord. So it's going to be Wolf versus DK.
Oh, boy.
I haven't seen Elric's Wolf for a very long time. So we'll see how this is. But after Watercraft taking out Shiny like that, I'm willing to believe anything could happen.
Yeah, nothing is impossible. So we'll see DK versus Wolf. And it's like you said, Watercraft has to do it with his livestock.
Jeez, what a crew battle this has turned out to be.
Yeah.
There's still a slim hope for the heroes, but I don't know. Can Watercraft keep it going just long enough to open the door for Squeesh to make something happen? I have not seen Elric's Wolf for quite a while, but it can be. I remember it being pretty formidable, so we're going to see how this works.
Yep, indeed. think WannaCraft has one thought left. It could go either very good or very bad. But we'll just have to
I'm guessing Elric's still going over strategy or something. I wonder what's taking him so long to get ready. I guess, yeah, it looks like I see icons going green in the villain's voice chat. They must be trying to sort something out. Alright, here we go!
DK versus Wolf.
Can WannaCraft come up huge for the second time? Or is Elric going to clean up the mess? And we're going to Pokemon Stadium 2.
And of course we have to sacrifice both of the stops there.
Alright, here we go.
And here we go.
DK versus Wolf, WannaCraft versus Elric. It's two players apiece for both teams tonight. And Elric's starting to get the early advantage here. Oh, nice get-up attack. Catches him with it. The rolling dash attack. Ooh, goes for the hand slap. Doesn't get it. Good shield. And nice roll attack. There's a forward air. Ooh! Side B's his way back. Now, unlike the other Spaceys, Wolf cannot stack his side B with his up B. Just something to keep in mind. So close to the blast line. Able to make it back. Yes, he... Ooh! Clutch air dodge! But an up tilt is going to take the stock! WannaCraft with a great start. Wait out the invincibility. And... Now Elric. Is he going to try to... Oh, tried to catch him on the landing. That probably would have ended it. That up smash is something fierce. It sucks you in on the initial hit. WannaCraft just trying to land. Uh-oh. Oh, that grab. If he had been able to keep that grab, that could have been the start of something. Oh, the grab! The cargo! Up air! Try to catch him with up tilt. Didn't do it. But WannaCraft needs to be extremely careful. A good back air or something could end it right here. This up B going to do decent. Woo! Dash attack.
WannaCraft is hanging tough.
Woo! Oh, and the down smash! And WannaCraft is out, but what a courageous effort. He does at least take a stock, but we're down to one man left for the hero's side.
Squishes Samus.
WannaCraft, I think, I want to believe he could have done something a little bit more, but could not. Couldn't overcome the fact that he was down to his last stock, so. Squeesh, you're the last hope for the heroes.
Squeesh is Samus.
This could be over very soon. I mean, I'm not gonna call it yet. But it's going to be a very tough fight, especially with Samus being a projectile-based character, and of course, Wolf has a reflector.
Yeah.
So we're going to see... I don't know, I don't want to say anything too soon. If Squeesh can at least bring it to... down to Ramen, if we can at least get the last of the villains, I mean, that would be an accomplishment. But the heroes might be dead to rights here, depending on what happens. I mean, there is no margin for error.
And Squeesh is in.
And it looks like we're going to go straight into it. All right, this is it. Potentially the final match of... this crew battle.
And
it all rests on Samus's shoulder pads.
And unfortunately, Elric has to sacrifice just one of his stops.
Here it is.
Here we go.
We're going to Yoshi's story. Whoa, what is Elric doing?
He made it back somehow.
Guess he thought he had to lose more than once. I'm not sure what happened there. Was he trolling?
Maybe, I don't know.
But we can't underestimate... Yep, there's a reflector. That's what I was talking about. That's definitely going to come into play. I think Elric is going to know... Elric has an idea exactly what he's going to have to do. But I'm not going to discount Squeesh here. His Samus is very capable.
Yep.
I'm not going to try to make too many... Oh, dear! Oh, he's got to try and make it back. He just does. Gets a get-up attack, cutting off whatever Elric was trying to... Ooh, Elric trying to catch him with the down smash. If Squeeze can just take a stock and get momentum. Tried to shine him! Oh, and he catches him landing. The landing lag off of the recovery, and there's a stock! Squeeze needed that. Can he bring it down to one more? Just... Oh, and he misses the charge shot! It wouldn't have killed, obviously, but it definitely would have been very, very important.
And very helpful for Squeeze, too.
If I'm Squeeze, I say just play lame. Lay bombs, do whatever you have to do. He has a reflector, yes, but you can still try to annoy him. Tries to cut him off with a down air, can't do it. Oh, and the dash attack, I believe that was. All right. Can Squeesh do what needs to be done? Can he do it?
We'll just have to see.
Gets the grab. Super missile. Elric does not drop through the platform. I think that was the read Squeesh was going for. Oh no, that up smash. He could not afford to take that. He can't afford to lose any other stocks. He cannot afford to go into a... No! He gets caught again. He cannot afford... Elric is just waiting for him. The dash attack. Misses the smash. Spot dodging. Shielding. He's trying everything. He's rolling. He's just trying everything to try to make something happen here. But a jab combo is going to send him back. Tries to catch him with the up smash again. So close. Tries to read him. And, oh, this could be the last stock for the heroes. Is Elric going to close it right here, right now? Ramen, you might just want to sit back and relax depending on how this goes. You might not even need to come out. Oh, good job catching him. Oh, and the dash attack's gonna send him off! And there is a faint sign of life for the heroes. It's very faint, but it is there.
Now the last, this is the last match of the crew battle. Samus versus Rid.
Somehow, some way, we're going to the final round. It is actually going to come down to the final matchup.
Samus versus Rid. And Squeesh might be in trouble because the thing about Ridley, he has his down B and his smash attack and all that stuff.
Yeah, no doubt. Very, very tough fight here for Squeesh. And he has to do it much like Watercraft had to try to do. It's one stock for Squeesh. There is no margin for error here.
This is the last map of the night.
Alright, we are down to two.
Two players on each side. Squeesh with Samus, Ramen with Ridley.
Ramen making the character selection. Alright. You want to believe that Squeesh can do it, but I think it's possible somehow. But like I said, I don't think it's probable. But we're going to find out. That's why they play the games. And here we go.
This is
it.
The last match. Squeak with Samus. Ramen with Ridley.
It's a canon matchup the way it should be.
Yes.
And we're going to Kalos.
Like
the final battle on Kalos.
Like always,
Squeesh has to sacrifice two stocks, though.
Get the words right out of my mouth. Anyway.
All right. This is it. Now we get serious.
And here we go.
And Ramen with the quick start out of the gate. Now, if I'm Squeesh, I say, again, just play lame. Just spam every... Oh, he spot dodges the down smash! Gets a down smash of his own... Oh, no.
This might get nasty.
Oh, he goes for the impale! I mean, Squeesh already at over 100%. He goes for it again. The grab, and this might just be... I hate to say it, it might just be a formality at this point.
Yeah, it might get nasty real quick.
It may just be a formality right now. I mean, Squeesh is trailing big here. He has not built much percent. Definitely not anywhere near any kind of kill percentage.
Really close to that. And barely avoid it.
And Ramen is just fishing. He wants that impale. He wants to end this in the most humiliating, stylish fashion possible. He wants to make this emphatic.
Indeed.
Just harmlessly jumps over the missile. The Squeesh hanging tough here. Oh my goodness, Ramen!
Ramen really wants it.
Ramen, you can just side B and end it right here. You don't need to do this. You can just side B and end it right now. You can just end it right here. Oh, he might be. Oh, he almost got it. Squeeze just narrowly getting out of the way. Oh, they lock up! Oh, down smash! Wait a minute. Squeeze? Squeeze?
Be careful.
Squeeze?
Be careful.
Squeeze! It's over.
The villains are victorious.
And Ramen, without losing a stock himself, will seal it. And with a final score of 3 stocks remaining to 0, the villains have won the day. It is all over.
In other words, the villains have defeated the heroes.
To make a reference to TV tropes, the bad guy wins.
Indeed.
But what a match. The remaining members of the heroes, Donkey Kong, I mean, Watercraft and Squeesh showed a tremendous amount of heart trying to keep things alive. They brought it down to the final game. But in the end, the villains will take the crew battle. Again, a final score, 3 stocks remaining to 0. That is going to conclude this stream of the Smash Grounds crew battle, Heroes versus Villains. The villains win. And that's going to go ahead and end. We're going to go ahead and end this stream right here. Thank you for those of you who tuned in to this stream. Hope everybody enjoyed it. This is the Atomic Punk. He has been Super Smash Bailey. We are signing out, and we hope to see you again soon.